Animal husbandry includes beekeeping and fisheries, in addition to cattle and poultry farming. Beekeeping, also known as apiculture, is the rearing of honeybees in artificial beehives called apiaries for the commercial production of honey. Honey is highly nutritious and an important constituent of several medicines. Also, the apiaries in which honeybees live and nurture the young ones are a source of beeswax. Beeswax is used in cosmetics and polish. Due to the increasing demand for honey, beekeeping is done both on small and large scale. In small scale beekeeping, one or two apiaries are kept in verandas or on rooftops. Whereas in large scale beekeeping, many apiaries are used, as the quality of the honey depends on the pasture available near the apiaries. Beekeeping is usually practiced near fruit plantations and cultivated fields. Honeybees act as the pollinators by helping crops like sunflower during flowering. In turn, they get nectar from the flowers. As a result, farmers get a high yield in terms of crops as well as honey. The most commonly reared honeybee species is Apis indica, also called the Indian bee. Although beekeeping is easy, it does require some knowledge and training that is provided by certain organizations. Some tips to be kept in mind are knowing the nature of the honeybees, selecting a desirable location for the beehives, controlling swarms, managing beehives during different climatic conditions, and collecting honey and beeswax. Following these tips will help carry out beekeeping successfully. Like beekeeping, fisheries are another part of animal husbandry. And relates to the rearing, catching and selling of aquatic animals such as fish and shellfish. As fish contain more proteins and less fat, they are preferred to other meats. Most commonly eaten freshwater fish include katla, rohu, and the common carp, while marine fish include hilsa, mackerel, and pomfret. Fisheries also provide products such as cod liver oil, which is a nutritional supplement, and pearl oysters that have commercial value. Consequently, it forms the livelihood of many people in coastal areas of India. As seafood like fish, prawn, crab, and lobster are always in demand, several techniques like aquaculture and pisciculture are employed to increase their yield. Aquaculture is the cultivation of aquatic animals and plants for food, whereas pisciculture refers specifically to fish farming. This dramatic increase in seafood production was called the Blue Revolution, compared to the Green Revolution that brought about an increase in agricultural production. India is an agricultural country with 62% of people engaged in agriculture for their livelihood. With the passage of time and an increase in population, the demand for food has risen extensively. Earlier, this was tackled through traditional farming and better management practices. However, it resulted in a very small increase in yield. It was only during the 1960s that the Green Revolution brought about a drastic increase in the production of high-yielding disease-resistant crops like wheat and rice by employing plant breeding techniques. Plant breeding involves crossing between plants with the desired characters to produce offspring that possess the superior character of both their parents. It dates back 9,000 to 11,000 years ago when conventional plant breeding was practiced. Conventional or traditional breeding is crossing plants for desirable characters sexually through self or cross-pollination or asexually through grafting. Most of the major crops such as wheat, rice and maize are the results of conventional breeding. On the other hand, classical breeding uses techniques such as mutation or tissue culture, followed by crossbreeding of pure lines and artificial selection of plants. The desirable characters of plants generated by plant breeding include high yielding with good quality, tolerance to different types of environmental stress, resistance to microbes and pests. Plant breeding is commonly carried out in government research institutes and some private organizations and involves several steps. The first step in plant breeding is the collection of germ plasm of a particular crop that is intended for breeding. Germplasm is the collection of all the genes of different varieties of a particular crop in the form of seeds or plants. In this way, the naturally available gene pool can be utilized for breeding. The second step is the selection of superior parents. Here, two plants with the different desired characters are selected from the available germ plasm. Then, they are made to self-cross to get a pure line of those varieties. The third step is cross-hybridization of the superior parents. This is done by collecting the pollen grains of one parent plant and placing them on the stigma of the other parent plant. However, the hybrids obtained may not contain all the desired characters present in the superior parents. In fact, 1 in 1000 or 2000 hybrids obtained may contain the desired characters of both superior parents. Hence, this step is considered cumbersome. The fourth step is the selection of superior hybrids. The desired hybrid is selected from the thousands of hybrids formed during crossbreeding that possess the characters of both its parents. Hence, it is considered superior than its parents. The hybrid is then allowed to self-pollinate till it forms a pure line of homozygous plants. The final step is the evaluation of the hybrid for the characters gained. This is done by first cultivating the hybrid in a research field under ideal conditions. Later, they are cultivated in farmers' fields at different locations for 3 growing seasons. This helps in comparing the performance of the hybrid against the best crop cultivar available in that area. In this way, plant breeding has increased the yield of many crops including wheat, rice, sugarcane, and millet. The Green Revolution is a result of using various plant breeding techniques to boost agriculture. During this period, there was a dramatic increase in the production of wheat from 11 to 75 million tons and rice from 35 to 89.5 million tons. The increase in production was credited to the semi-dwarf varieties of wheat and rice that were developed. The semi-dwarf wheat varieties was first developed at the International Center for Wheat and Maize Improvement in Mexico by Nobel Laurel Norman E. Borlaug. Likewise, the semi-dwarf rice variety IR8 was developed at the International Rice Research Institute IRRI in the Philippines. Later, better yielding varieties of wheat hybrids such as Sonalika and Kalyan Sona and rice hybrids such as Jaya and Ratna were developed in India. In the case of sugarcane, Saccharum Barberi and Saccharum Officinarum were crossbred to get a hybrid. The hybrid obtained had both the characters of its parents, such as a very thick stem with a higher sugar content and the ability to grow in northern parts of India. Similarly, high-yielding hybrids of millet such as Johar and Bajra, which are resistant to water scarcity, were also developed in India. In this manner, through various plant breeding techniques, many high-yielding crops were developed that helped boost in Indian agriculture.